Welcome back to Digital Marketing by Gina. My name is Gina Wicentowich, and I am a digital marketing strategist that has worked with a variety of businesses. From small tech startups to large corporate companies, I'm sharing my top tips for your digital marketing strategies for 2019. So today, we are specifically going to talk about e-commerce email marketing strategies. And the reason is because I love e-commerce. I think it is very effective and it's easy to see results if you do things smart. So today I thought I would sit down and share some of my top email marketing strategies for success, especially because we are slowly starting to roll into the season for Black Friday. So this is a time to start planning your email campaigns, your advertising strategies, and your product marketing for e-commerce. Now, one thing I just wanted to note is whether you use MailChimp, ActiveCampaign, or Constant Contact, it doesn't matter. It's all about the strategy. There's a way to have a really smart, effective e-commerce strategy, but there's also a way to send a lot of generic emails that don't go opened. And especially when you consider that the average user receives 120 emails a day, we gotta up our game and we gotta be ready to have effective email strategy. Now, one other stat I wanted to throw at you is that the average open rate for an email is 15%. And the average click-through rate, which means someone actually clicking on links within that email, is 3.1%. Now, if you pull up your Gmail right now and you go to the promotions folder, you're gonna have, I wanna say, at least 20 unopened emails. You get a lot of emails from brands, especially e-commerce brands, trying to get you to purchase something. So how do we stand out in that inbox? Well, let's get into it. The first tip that I have for you is segment your email campaigns. This is effective within any industry, B2B, B2C, but most effective with e-commerce, and you're going to see the highest ROI when you do this. Now, one of the great things about email is that you own that data. You own those subscriber lists, they're yours. One of the kind of risky pieces of pay-per-click advertising, whether Facebook, Instagram, or Google, is that they have the power. They hold the power in that relationship because if they change an algorithm, if they decide to suspend your account, well, things aren't gonna work out well for you. But email, you have direct power in that relationship. So within that dynamic, use all the tools at your fingertips. So MailChimp is the most popular email marketing platform, and MailChimp and all of the other top email platforms out there, they all have really great tools for segmentation. So you can take your list, your customer or subscriber list, and actually make it very segmented. So some of the top segments you'll see is people that have made a purchase within the last 6 months, people that have never made a purchase, and people that are actively engaged with your email marketing campaigns. Now, what you do with those different segments is that you customize the email sent to them with having a subject line, text, and products that are customized to those audiences. So if you have someone that has never purchased anything from your store before, but somehow they're subscribed to your list, well, give them something to incentivize them to shop from you. Have a coupon code, have a special discount, get their attention somehow. The text you would use in that email is very different than you would use to a very loyal customer that has purchased from you in the last 6 months, if not the last month in itself. When you segment your email campaigns effectively in e-commerce, you will see a 15% increase in the open rate, which, if you can do the math and correlate that to sales, that's a lot of money. Now, my second tip, and this I don't see people talking about enough, but it is huge and it is so simple. Use emojis in your subject lines. Now, even B2B brands, there is nothing wrong with using an emoji, a relevant emoji in your subject lines for email campaigns. But e-commerce has so many advantages. The shopping bag, the money emoji, the running emoji, the fire emoji. How many times have we seen sale is now on, fire emoji? Now, stats actually show that brands that use emojis in their subject lines will have a 56%, yes, 56% increase in their open rate. And that's a huge, powerful tool. If you go back to your Gmail promotions folder and you open it up and you give it a quick scan, the things that will pop out at you immediately are those subject lines that have emojis. Emojis are visual. We're tapping into that need for humans to see visuals and gravitate towards them. So it's very powerful. So think of different ways that you can actually just tweak your subject line to have an emoji so you can take advantage of that need for people to see visuals and then gravitate towards them. Now my third tip is have a clear call to action. Now that sounds simple. We want to have a clear button to direct the user where to go. But the thing with emails is that there's so many different pieces. You're thinking about the design, you're thinking about the image, the product showcase, and the text on the page that sometimes the last thing people think about is the call to action. But don't make it confusing. Have one call to action, have it consistent throughout that so the person can look at that email and within 3 seconds know exactly what they should do. Now, don't leave that call to action at the very bottom of the email. Have it above the fold right when they see the email and at the bottom. Have it be consistent, but also have it be powerful. Shop popular products, shop brand new product, click to save 10%. Whatever your call to action may be, just don't forget that that is the whole purpose of the email, is directing the person to that button to get them to your website. So give it a little bit more thought sometimes than just adding a quick button with some text at the bottom of an email. Think clearly about how can I direct this user segment to the website? What will be the best call to action to incentivize them to shop from us? Now, one little thing that the analytics expert in me had to throw in this video is that don't forget, with all the links in your email campaigns, please use UTM parameters. Those will allow you to customize how those links appear in your source/medium report in Google Analytics. That way you can really clearly see how people got to your website and what they did once they arrived. So have things such as source equals MailChimp/Spring Promo 1, so that you really clearly can find how people are engaging from those email campaigns. Even if they didn't purchase something, you can see what they did on your website. Now, I hope you found those 3 tips for your e-commerce email marketing strategy helpful. And if you have any questions related to email marketing, please leave me a comment down below or send me a direct message on LinkedIn, Twitter, or Instagram, and I am happy to help. My goal is to have you have the most powerful and effective e-commerce email marketing strategy for 2019. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned.